Welcome to the Makeup Box, and if you are viewing for the first time, it's good to have you here as well. Feel free to hit the subscribe button, also that notification bell, so that you can be notified when new content is uploaded to this channel. Today we're going to be doing a simple black smoky eye, and this is dubbed for prom. So if you want to see how I achieve this look, then let's go. Okay, so we're going to be using some primer today, and I am just using my fingertips to rub in this Urban Decay Primer Potion, and that is the original one I'm using, and I'm just laying it down on my eyelids just to prime the eyes. Now, to further give our brows a nice, clean, crisp line, I'm going to be using some of the LA Girl Pro Conceal in Warm Honey, and I'm just carving up my brows and we're feathering that down into the crease as well, and then we're going to blend that out. So I'm just using an angled brush, and this brush came in a set from the BH Cosmetics Pink Dot line, and so I'm just using this, and we're doing the same thing as we did on the other brow. We're just feathering that down into the crease, the product into the crease, and we're just gonna blend it out as well. Now, as you can see, my eyelids are very dark. I have dark circles around my eyes, so I want to work with an even canvas, so I'm just using some of that Warm Honey concealer from LA Girls, and we're just going to apply that to my eyelids, and we're going to blend it out nice and evenly because we don't want any creasing from the concealer. So that is what we're doing, and the brush I'm using is from Coastal Scents. It's one of their blending brushes. And here I'm going in with some of that LA Girl HD Translucent Powder, and I'm just setting that concealer to ensure that the concealer does not move and it stays in place. So using this Royal & Nanicle brush that I got in my BoxyCharm box for this month, I'm using that to set my brow bone area, and the color that I'm using is Chamois Nude, and it's very pretty, it's smooth, and it's from Coastal Scents. It's one of their hot pots. So as my transitional color, I'm going in with this orange rusty tone, and this is from one of my Santee Matte Dual palettes. The palette does not have names, I think it goes by numbers, but I'll be leaving that in the description box below. But yeah, I'm using windshield wiper motions, and I'm just blending back and forth to get the pigmentation that I want, and yeah, we're doing that. So out of that same palette, there is this dark brown shade, and I'm using that in my crease area for more depth and to define the crease some more. I'm layering this eyeshadow because working with black shadows later on, you want something that will help to blend out that harsh blackness per se. So you know, we're just layering these colors. We're going from the orange and gradually into the chocolate browns. Okay, so we're going in with another shadow, and this one is Cherry Cola from Makeup Geek, and I'm using a dome shaped brush from my Coastal Scents 22-piece set, and I'm just packing that color in there. We're layering these colors because we want a lot of depth and dimension, so I'm just packing that color in there, and we're just blending out. So I'm going back in with that first transitional color, and I'm not applying extra pigment to that. I'm just using the same brush, and I'm just blending out because we don't want to lose that color. So I'm just retouching and erasing any harsh lines. So for my eyeshadow base, I'm going in with this LA Girl eyeshadow primer, and this is in the color black, and I'm just applying this sparingly, and then we're going to go in with a blending brush. This was purchased off of eBay, just a regular blending brush, and I'm just using that, and I'm blending out that black. Black is so tricky to work with, but you want to take your time and you want to really blend it out to avoid creasing. So blend, blend, blend. So I'm going in with this concealer brush, and this is also from the Coastal Sands 22 piece brush set, and I'm taking the black out of the Reveal 2 palette, which is so pigmented, and I'm just blending that out. It's soft and it really gets the job done. Easiest black I've had to work with. So just pack this onto your lid and just blend out. Go back in with your last crease color and blend out any harsh lines, and you are good to go, honey. So I'm going in with my face primer, and this is the Too Faced Hangover Replenishing Primer. I love this. It leaves my skin all hydrated and I can't get enough of it. This is like one of my go-tos. Okay, so as I mentioned before that I have dark circles, I also have acne scarring. So I'm just going to use this LA Girl Orange Corrector, and I love this because it's very easy to blend out. And a little goes a long way because it can have you really orange. You don't want to look like an Oompa Loompa. So I'm just going to take this foundation brush and I'm just going to blend that out. And this was also in a set from BH Cosmetics. Now that we've already color correct, we're going to go in with some primer. And I'm using one of my all-time favorites, which is the Becca Ever Matte Flawless Priming Perfector. Love this. Reminds me of the Milk of Magnesia. We're going to apply this to the T-zone. So next, I'm going to take my EOS lip balm and I'm just going to moisturize my lips. This lip balm really leaves my lips hydrated, so that's why I love to have it on hand at all times, because it does a good job. So here we have one of my favorite foundations, and I'm sure you guys have seen it debuted a whole lot on my channel, but I'm taking the Mary Kay Bronze 607, and I love this foundation because it's medium to full coverage and it dries down to a powder consistency and it lasts practically all day, all night. So hence why it is like one of my favorites. I'm just taking a foundation brush and I'm just blending this out, and then I'll go in with a beauty sponge and I'll just buff it more into the skin. So now we're gonna conceal and highlight the areas where we wanna attract light. So I'm using the Milani Retouch and Erase, and it says that it is a light lifting concealer. So I'm just gonna apply this underneath my eyes, the bridge of my nose, cupid's bow, chin, forehead. We're just gonna highlight those areas using this, and it's very smooth. I still kind of love my LA Girl Pro Conceal HD Concealers because they are just bomb. But this is a good product. I don't regret investing in it, but I still have my LA Girl Pro Concealers. So I'm taking some of the Sasha Buttercup setting powder and I'm setting my under eye concealer. I did have to go in with some of the Black Opal Neutral Light to kind of give it the color that I wanted. This wasn't doing it too much for me on its own, so I mixed the two powders and I was kind of satisfied with the outcome. So yeah, we're just gonna set the concealer underneath our eyes, forehead, bridge of the nose, cupid's bow, chin. You get the gist. Thank you. So we were looking a little flat. So to bring some dimension back to the face, we're gonna bronze up, and I'm using a little bit of the Black Opal Mineralized Loose Powder. And I think the color is deep or dark. The information will be linked below. You guys know that, so you can just check it out to be sure, you know. So we're just gonna bronze up the hollows of the cheek, forehead, jawline, you know how it go. Before we contour, yeah. So contouring, I'll be using this contour palette from Coco Couture Cosmetics, and they are based in Nassau, and it's so good when we can support each other, you know. The product is good and the colors are very pigmented. I enjoyed using it. This was my first time using it and it popped off really nice. So congrats to you, baby girl. Great product. Okay, so to bring some definition back to the eyes, we're gonna just add those colors onto our lower lash line, and we're practically just repeating the steps that we did on the lid down on the lower lash line. So those, that orange and those browns and also the black, you just want to blend them seamlessly and it will tie the look together. As you can see, the look is coming together very nicely. So yeah, you know, this is prom, you know, you want to look fly, you want to look fleeky, you know. I didn't have prom, so I have to take joy in this. So just taking this brush, we're just gonna blend everything together. So we're gonna add some color to the apples of our cheeks, and this blush is from LA Girls and it has some gold flecks in it. It's very pretty, and we're just gonna layer this on top of that flawless foundation, and yeah, we're gonna get this going for prom. Next, we're just gonna set all of this with some of the Milani Prep and Prime spray. I really love this. It really gets the job done. You know, I had to go heavy on it because it felt so good. So next, we're gonna line our waterline, and I'm using that same pencil that we applied for our eyeshadow base. We're just gonna pop that into our waterline and tie this look all together. And then for a pop of glow, I'll be using the Coastal Scents. This is what? The Coastal Scents bronzer, and this is in light. On light skin people, it would be a bronzer, but on darker skin persons, you know, it would be considered as a highlight. So I'm just taking this VH Cosmetics blending brush, and I'm applying that on top of my cheeks, on the forehead, chin. Then we're gonna apply some to our nose and Cupid's bow, and we're just gonna blend this out all nicely. So here I'm adding some right there. I don't even know what to call this because on my eyes it just shapes so funny. Like, I don't really have an inner corner that can be so defined, so I just pop some of the highlight there and call it a day. But I love that. So this is one of the fun parts of this video, applying this glitter liner. Obviously a black liner would not have been noticeable, so I opted to use this glitter, and it's by NYX. It has little green, orange, and purple flecks in it, black flecks. So I thought it was very nice to just pop this on to the lash line and get it going. It was giving me a hard time. It was sitting here for quite a bit, and I literally had to shake it up to get the product flowing again. But after that, it was a breeze. So next, we're just applying some mascara to our lashes, and I'm using the Maybelline Colossal Big Shot Mascara. Had to have it, guys. You gotta get it. You gotta cop it. It's that good. So we've applied our lashes off camera, and these are the Kate lashes in 76. And next we're gonna line our lips using the NYX liner in Cola, and then we're gonna fill them in with MAC Ruby Woo. So if you enjoyed watching this tutorial, don't hesitate to share, comment, like, subscribe. You know, if you haven't subscribed as yet, don't hesitate to click that subscribe button, also the notification bell, so that you can always be alerted when I upload new content. So thank you for watching, take care, and goodbye.